Yesterday, in the previous class, we have discussed with the concepts of trigonometric equations, inverse, hyperbolic, delta. Today, we are going to discuss some concepts in properties of triangles. In properties of triangles, we know that in triangle ABC, generally small a is the length of the side BC, small c is the length of the side AB, and small b is the length of the side AC. Okay? Now again, what is delta? Delta is area of the triangle. 2S is what? Perimeter of the triangle. And the chapter is circumradius. Small r is in radius. So this is in circle. The circle which is the circle of the triangle. Whose radius is small? This is called in circle. Whose radius is smaller? This is what? Circumcircle. Which is passes through vertices of the triangle? ABC. Similarly, small r1, small r2, small r3 are radii of excircles opposite to capital A, capital B, capital C. So we know the formulas for already we have discussed in IP also. Practice all the formulas thoroughly. First, what is the first formula? Sine rule. A equal to 2 r sine A, B equal to 2 r sine B, C equal to 2 r sine C. Similarly, cosine rule, projection rule, modulus rule, half angle formula, formulas for delta. What is the formula for delta? Delta equal to what? This is ABC by 4R. Similarly, root of S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Again, this is delta equal to 2 R square sine A sine A sine C. Another one, half BC sine A, half AB sine C, half CA sine A. We have here many formulas for delta. What is 2S? A plus B plus C, which is perimeter of the triangle. So, practice all the formulas already mentioned IP. Okay. Moreover, we are having some formulas, extra formulas. See, these are also we are having in India. Small r, in radius, first formula delta by s, second formula is 4r sin a by 2 sin b by 2 sin c by 2. R1, R2, R3. And these are the formulas for tan a by 2. Tan a by 2 formula, delta by s into s minus a, tan b by 2, delta by s into s minus b, tan c by delta by s into s minus a. R1 formula, R4. Now come to the concept. Now, if h is the opposite of the triangle, you see, the distance from the vertex capital A to the outer center, AH distance, 2 R cos A. BH distance, 2 R cos B. CH distance is 2 R cos. So, I am going to do this now. Take the triangle ABC. D is, AD is the altitude drawn from A. BE is the altitude drawn from B. This is 90, because this is altitude, this is also 90 there. So, this is 90. Now, I am going to find the value of, I am going to prove BH distance. Similarly, you can do AH and CH also. See here, if this is 90, this is total angle B. Is it right? Total angle B. 90 plus B. Then what is this angle? This angle? 90 minus B. Is it right or not? Then another right angle angle. This one. Triangle ABE. This is 90. This is completely A. Now what is this angle? 90 minus B. Understood that? Now how can we get this angle? This one, this small angle, this is total B minus this one. That means total angle B minus of 90 degrees minus of angle B. Understood or not? If you want to get this small angle, okay, total B minus 90 minus A. Understood or not? So take the minus inside one get one. Minus of minus plus. Is this is directly A plus B minus 90? Is it right or not? So what is A plus B? 180 minus C. What is 90 minus 90? 90 minus. Understood or not? That's why this is small angle is 90 degrees minus. Now I am taking a, first of all, from the triangle ABD, I am taking cos B. What is cos B? Inside angle of an angle, adjacent side by hypotenuse. This is small c. We know the length of the side AB is a small c. Cos B is equal to BD by C. Is it right now? What is BD? C cos B. Now take in this triangle, which triangle? Triangle BHD, I am applying the cos of 90 minus C. What is cos of 90 minus in this triangle? Again, adjacent side by hypotenuse. That means, like what is adjacent side here? BD by BH. After cos multiplication, BD equal to what? This is a cos 90 minus theta, sin theta, BH into sin C. Already we know the value of BD. Substitute here, this is what? C cos B is equal to BH sin C. We know from sine rule, small c equal to 2 r sin c. 2 r sin c cos b equal to bh sin c. Sin c gets cancelled. What is the value of bh? to the opposite from the primary axis. Similarly, what is AH to arc AC? What is CH to arc AC? Understood or not? Next one. Similarly, I am going to do. Similarly, here, let us observe. There have been conditions in this concept only. Again, already we got AH equal to 2 arc AC, BH equal to just 2 arc AC, CH equal to 2 arc AC. Now, what is the distance from ortho center H to its opposite side? That distance is there. This is total distance AD. Already we got AH is 2 arc AC. This is the distance from the vertex A to the opposite side. Now, what is this distance? HD. The distance from the ortho center H to the opposite side. How can you find the length of the HD? See here, I am going to take this one. In this triangle only, apply sin 90 minus C. Okay? Take sin. What is sin 90 minus C in this small triangle? BHD, tell me. This is what? HD, opposite to hypotenuse. What is hypotenuse? BH. Understood or not? Sin 90 minus theta, cos theta. So, what is HD? BH. Sin 90 minus C is what? Cos C. So this is R we got BH. How much you get now? 2 R cos B cos C. I think you remember now. HD distance. The distance from the ortho center H to its opposite side BC is 2 R cos B cos C. The distance from the ortho center H to its angular opposite side AC is 2 R cos A cos C. The distance from H to AD is given by 2 R cos A cos C. So these are the 6 distances we have to remember. AH 2 R cos A, HD 2 R cos B cos C. BH distance 2 R cos B, HE 2 R cos A cos C. Something like that. Okay. Moreover, we know the length of the longitude drawn from capital A to its opposite BC is given by 2 delta by small a. How can we get that now? See, take AD. From this triangle, what is AD? AH plus HD. Understood? What is AH we got? Generally, this is what? 2 R cos A. What is HD distance we got here? 2 R cos B cos A. If you remember the formula to find the length of the longitude drawn from A is given by 2 delta by small a. If you simplify this, you will get this one. How can we simplify this? Take 2 R a common. Anyway, or else you can apply some formula for, you know, if you convert this in the terms of delta, you will get the answer. Understood or not? Right. Now, next one is. How to find the distance from the vertex of the triangle to its in center? That formula is also there. Actually, proofs are not necessary, but if you know the proof, you will get the logic. Next one, take the triangle. This is A, B, C. Now, this is circumcircle. For example, if you take this is a circle. Okay? Okay, whose center is what? Capital A. Understood? Now join this. This is what? What is capital A? In center. In center is point of congruence of what? Angular bisectors. If you extend this, this is angular bisector, this is also angular bisector. Remember, this is the angle. This is capital A. Now this angle is what? B by 2. Is it B by 2 or not? Right, this is B by 2. So the point of congruence of angular bisectors is called in center. In center is center of in center. Understood by that? Now how can you find AI or ID? Or else how can you find AI? Can you tell me? So AI distance or ID distance we have to find. Now let us find the distance from the vertex capital A to in-center capital A. Okay? See, in-center is the point of congruence of what? Angular bisectors. This is A by 2, A by 2. This is B by 2, A by 2. Understood that? So, take the sine rule in the triangle ABI. In the triangle ABI. And then you got sine rule. For example, I have taken AI. So, this is AI by. What is the angle opposite to AI? B by 2. So, this is sine B by 2. Is equal to. What is the angle here? B by 2 is there. A by 2, this is BI. This is BI by what? BI by like sin a right. And again what? AB by E. Angle opposite to AB. This angle. This angle how much you get now? This is A by 2 plus B by 2 plus angle AIB equal to 180. Is it right or not? AIB plus remaining two angles is 180. So this is how much you get here. Angle AIB is equal to 180 degrees. Take it as A plus B by 2. So this is, so keep the angle like this. Okay? So this is what? Sine AIB. AIB means what? 180 degrees minus of A plus B. Okay? Right. Next one. I am equating first one and last one. See here. This is AI by sin B by 2 equal to AB. AB this is how much? Small c. By sin 180 minus theta is what? Sin theta. So this is sin A plus B by 2. Again, this is AI by sin B by 2 equal to this is C by A plus B means 180 minus C. So this is how much we get now? 90 minus C by 2. So 90 minus C by 2 is what? Cos theta. This is small c, length of the side. This is capital C. So from this, what is the value of AI? Take a question. Small c into sin B by 2 by cos C by 2. From sin rule, what is C? 2 r sin C into sin B by 2 by cos C by 2. Again from the formula of multiple angles, how can you write sin C? 2 sin C by 2 cos C by 2 into what? Sin B by 2 by cos C by 2. So what is this cancel here? Cos C by 2 is cancel. So after what we know, 2 into 2 r. This is the 4 r. Sin A by 2 is not there. 1 will be multiplying with sin A by 2 and dividing with what? Sin A by 2. So then our answer will get now. Sin A by 2. Is it right or not? What is the value of numerator? Is numerator is the formula for small r, second formula. So this is how much we get now? R by sin A by 2. What is the reciprocal of sin? Cosecant. So the formula is given by R cosecant A by 2. Therefore, AI. How much we get now? R cosecant A by 2. What is BI? R cosecant B by 2. CI, R cosecant C by 2. So this is the way how to find the distance between the vertex to outer center and the vertex to in center. Not only this, again we can find the distances from the distances between I and I1, II1, II2, II3. That means the distance between in center and exit center. And again we can prove the values, the formulas between the distance from the vertex capital A to its in center opposite capital A, I1, B, I2, something like that. Understood? That's all.